Hello and welcome to Beneath the... Why am I doing that?
Okay, in the zone.
Hello and welcome to Beneath the Surface, our sneak peek into the inner workings of all things Microsoft Surface. We introduce you to the creative people behind the scenes who make these innovative devices a reality. I'm your host, Sonia Dara, and today we'll be talking about the hybrid workplace. Hopefully you've heard about it by now. And we'll also be talking about one of my favorite products, the Surface Hub. I'm excited to be coming to you today from one of our partners' locations, Steelcase's new Work Better Lab that they co-developed with their partners OpenSquare and Porter. Steelcase has always pushed the forefront on how teams can better collaborate and communicate together. As we start to navigate post-pandemic life, we thought it would be a great idea to dig deeper into how work life has evolved over the past year. You know, there were some big challenges to overcome, to say the least. Teams that were used to physically working together had to adjust to new ways of communicating. And many companies, including Microsoft, had to quickly reevaluate how to make products and services work for customers. Now people are adjusting again, and this time to a hybrid work environment that is pretty much here to stay. So how do you take the design, engineering, and manufacturing of our biggest Surface device ever, a process that usually is done side by side in person in China or in the US, and how do you translate that process into a remote or hybrid environment? The Surface team had to navigate this very question while working during the lockdown in 2020. Today, joining me to talk about Surface Hub and the design process are Senior Director of Hardware Development, Peter Oehler, and Principal Hardware PM, Christy Winslow. I'm so happy to have both of you here. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having us.
Happy to be here.
Awesome, so we'll start super easy. Why don't you tell all of us a little bit more about your roles and what you do for Surface? Peter, why don't we start with you?
Hi, I'm Peter Oehler. I lead a hardware development team that designs and delivers our Surface Hubs. And I've had the privilege to be working on Surface Hubs since the very beginning. And I see you're using a Surface Hub 50 now. It's always nice to see them in the wild in use. That never gets old.
Hi, I'm Christy Winslow. I was the lead development program manager for the 85-inch, working with the teams to define the product, building the business case, create the specs, and then executing engineering builds to validate the design and eventually releasing into production.
Awesome. You know, we'd love to start, let's go chronologically. You know, prior to COVID, what was the hub building process like? You're working on literally the largest physical device we have in the portfolio. How was the remote and hybrid work and during the pandemic? How did it shape product production? And what did you have to do for, you know, the team to all adapt now to this new environment?
Oh, wow. Everything changed overnight. We were deep in the development of Surface Hub 85. Extensive testing was underway in our labs. We were preparing for an upcoming build. And with campus closed and no travel to our factories, we had to stop and assess how we could move forward. For a few folks, we had to get test devices and equipment to their home. And we set up test labs in their garages and their basements and such. We quickly dispersed every pre-production 50-inch hub we had to our team's home offices. And we set about finalizing the development of this complex product without being able to see the parts, pre-production units, or travel to our factory. One of the new and exciting tools we used to collaborate with the factory was HoloLens. With our engineers in the factory, they would have a HoloLens on as they walked the line with a bunch of us connected in remotely. The improvement in visualization with the camera tightly coupled to what the engineer on the line was looking at was fantastic.
It sounds like you had a lot more hoops to jump through to get your team to continue working on it. So I'm glad you're able to do it safely. And also, you know, it sounds like it was pretty effective. Were there any positive outcomes that came out of, you know, this new way of working and, you know, how you're thinking maybe about some processes moving forward and continuing using?
Yeah. We had some really great successes on the 85-inch program. We were fortunate that the program started before the pandemic hit. We had a very modest-sized team and budget. So that required us to trust and rely on the teams across the board from the start. So we were already in that mode. And then once the pandemic hit, it was just amplified. And then another area where I think everyone grew was having patience with each other. We're developing these very complex products across time zones and languages and cultures, and then you throw in work from home. So I think that's carried over, and it really helped the team bond.
Yeah, I totally hear that across the board. More empathy for other coworkers. You know, it's a global health pandemic everyone's dealing with on a personal basis, plus your workload. You both have such amazing backgrounds and knowledge in the hardware world. You know, Peter, I believe you have, what, almost 30 years of experience? And I would love to understand, in your opinion, what do you think the industry is going to take away from the last 18 months? Like, how are we now thinking about the hybrid workplace with these devices?
Building products and keeping a team in sync when we can't all be together, it's hard. In all the ways we've learned to build new products over that last 30 years, it just doesn't work the same way when we're all remote. 18 months ago, I would have told you that product design with a fully remote team was really gonna be tough. But now, with effort and ingenuity, I can happily report that it's possible. With COVID, we had to further distribute responsibility and decision-making out to more people in more places across the world. And our products and our product making are better for it.
I love that. Kudos to you all for making it happen. Thank you so much for joining us today. Appreciate all of your time.
It's been great to be here.
Yes, thank you. Thank you very much.
A huge thank you to Peter and Christy for sharing so many insights into how the manufacturing and engineering processes have changed during our remote and hybrid work environments. It's awesome. So devices like the Surface Hub have clearly Devices like the Surface Hub have clearly helped us to adjust to the hybrid workplace, making sure those who are still working from home are still well represented and visible on the screen at the office. And as we just heard from the team, it's worked out really well. Now, another thing that's great about the Surface Hub is that there's...
Cutting
to commercial?
Yeah, you gotta cut to the commercial.
Since when do we have commercials?
We just added a couple.
Oh. Apparently we have a commercial.
As the world reopens, people are returning to their offices instead of working from home. But why? Sure, you get to see friends and eat lunch and do whatever you do outside of the house, because honestly, it's a mystery. But at this office, are there cute and fuzzy friends who will lick your face on demand? No. Do you get to dole out constant tummy rubs to loyal companions? No. Do you get to give yum-yum treats to your oopsie-boopsie little babies whenever they ask you for it? No. The choice is clear. Work from home. It's the only way. This message brought to you by dogs and a few cats, but not as many.
You heard the dog. Get a Surface and you can work from anywhere. Okay, so back to Surface Hub. We heard it from all of you in the comments section last month. You want to see the prototypes. You want to see the cool stuff behind the scenes. You want to see all the crazy tech. And we are here for it. I am super excited to have Neil O'Connell, director and mechanical engineer, coming to us live, Bill Nye the Science Guy style, from Building 86 on Microsoft's campus, where they have a super secret Surface Hub lab chock full of all their coolest stuff. Let's see what Neil can show us.
Okay, welcome to the Surface Hub 2S 85. 85 inches diagonal, an unbroken sea of pixels on a large piece of glass. From an engineering point of view, our major issue that we have to deal with here is weight, right? This is a big, heavy product. Weight and flatness. The glass needs to be perfectly flat. The glass doesn't want to be flat. It wants to sag. Right? It's got its own mind, right? Now, we need to support it, but we can't support it from underneath because one of the Surface principles is that it's pixels first. So you'll notice on a Surface 85 or even a Surface Pro or a Surface laptop, actually the glass is the first thing you come to on the product. And we did the same thing here. It meant that we had to support the glass only from behind and only at its outer edge. So, we built a beautiful aluminum frame to bond to the back of the glass. Another challenge we have because of the size of this product is in warmer environments, this product will actually be bigger because the materials will expand. And it can be as much as 2 millimeters bigger in a warm room than a cool room, right? So what we did we split the bezel into four pieces. So as the product expands, the bezels follow the edge of the glass outwards and they don't interfere with the video that you see in front of you. Another thing that was important, and if you come around to here, you'll see the overall thickness of the product was extremely important as well for a couple of reasons. One reason is accessibility. When you mount a product to a wall, you don't want it to protrude too far from the wall. It becomes a safety hazard. So with our partners in Steelcase, we designed a thin product and then they developed a wall mount that would hold the product less than 100 millimeters from the wall, which meant they had 15 millimeters to work with. We delivered an 85 millimeter product, 100 millimeters from the wall. Super thin. Then if you look at the back over here, if you look at the back of the product, one of the interesting things when you look at the back of this product is it probably doesn't look like the back of similar sized screens like large TVs that you'd see elsewhere, right? Number one, obviously it's beautiful looking, but what's interesting is what isn't there. There are no separations between the panels. It's a single piece. And this is actually the largest injection mold that Surface has ever built. It's a single piece. Another thing you don't see that you would have expected to see are exposed screws. There are no exposed screws back here. It's engineered to be attached in a different way. We used what we called floating snaps. And then if we come over here, we take off the bump cover, we see some of the main components of the PC, right? So we have it's a modular PC design. So these modules can be swapped in and out. You don't have to send the whole product back. On the back, we've got a number of components in here, like any other PC, that actually get quite hot. So in order to keep them cool, we push air in the direction the air wants to go, right? Hot air rises, so up through here. We've got two fans pushing through a PSU and across the heatsink for the computer here. Now, we also, because this is a Teams-certified device, it sets a very high performance bar for microphones and speakers. In this case, the microphones wanted to be along the top edge. It's a beamforming microphone array. So you'll note that we've directed the air to one side and to the other to avoid the microphones along the top. And we've designed the curvature of the rear cover to guide the air past the microphones and over the top. And that's it from the bump.
Okay, real talk, I loved that tour. I've gotten to work on the Surface Hub for a couple years now, but all the details behind the engineering involved to make a product like that a reality, an 85-inch device like that, it's mind-blowing, it's insane. Okay, let's do a little recap of what we learned today. All right, so we learned that teams can be creative, productive, and connected even when they aren't working together in person, and even when they're working on the largest Surface product ever. It's clear that hybrid work is here to stay. So Microsoft actually recently conducted a study on work health, and the results really do say it all. Here's some stats for you. All right, 66% of businesses said that they are considering redesigning their offices to support hybrid work. 77% of employees said that they want flexible remote work options, while 67% want more in-person work or collaboration once things reopen post-pandemic. And a whopping 46% of people surveyed say they plan to move to new locations within the next year, proving that people are now able to pursue their career goals no matter where they live. And even the way we interact with our coworkers has changed. 18% of employees surveyed said they have met a coworker's pet or family member virtually. And all those happy hours and the like cat runs across the screen, like, best part of my day. You can read more results from the Work Health Research Study from Microsoft at the link below. All right, well, that about wraps it up for this month's episode. I know, we're all sad. We want to give a big special shout out to our friends at Steelcase for hosting us in their incredible space for this month's episode. And to you, thank you so much for joining us. Make sure you leave a comment below. You know, let us know, how has hybrid work affected you this past year? You know, what are device features you would like to see to help make your hybrid work environment more productive? And most important question of today, what's your favorite Jackie Chan movie? We want to hear it all. Thanks again, and don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel. We hope you'll come back for next month's episode. See you then.
Get back to business.
There's nothing in my teeth, right?
Everybody here is completely hungover.
Where do you want me to look?
So imagine, if you will, the scene from Lord of the Rings where they're making orcs. It's kind of that way, right?
I'm going to turn into Jackie Chan soon. Be careful.
Hopefully you've heard this. Otherwise, you've been under a rock.